mwe mnaelewa. Kwa hii so gisi nilikuwa nawaambia tutaongelea kuhusu mambo ya mawazo gisi mnajua mawazo njo kintu yenye natuletea ila tujisikie mzuri au tujisikie mbaya kufuatana na vyenye tunafanya nini vyenye tunawaza kama unawaza vya mzuri itakuletea kujisikia mzuri na utaishi mzuri lakini kama uko nawaza vitu ya mubaya itakuletea kujisikia mubaya na kile kitu utaona kama uko na shindo kwa ajili ya nini ya mawazo so sana sana na huyu mama nilikuwa nimeshamwambia kama tutaongelea ile mambo ya mawazo na kujua mawazo ni nini mawazo inaweza fanya nini so taendelea dai kumsikiliza ni nini anaweza tushauria kufuatana na mawazo so Shailia, you are most welcome and I was already explaining them how we shall share today about the role of thought like the wrong use of thought and the right use of thought and I have already told them that if they are still thinking much more of the past as we have been sharing to them they won't get positive results and unless they change the thought and they start living positive but I already told them that you are going to share much about that so we are so much welcoming you to this group where this group is this is called Nyarugugu it is also in Nakivale Refugee Settlement and this group is for Banyamulenge they come from Congo DRC Congo and they have faced a lot of hardship there because most of them here were farmers doing cattle rearing there but almost each one of these they have lost their cows over 30 40 even 100 these people and they are now living here even getting water is hard and they used to have hint of milk in their homeland but they are here in Nakivale living in a hardship and we are happy that through our teachings they have been able to acquire hope through three principles on what we are sharing to them so I will welcome you to this group and of course you will be sharing into English and I will be translating to them in Kiswahili
okay yes are you ready You can hear me well, Phillips?
Yes, yes. Can hear you.
Yes. So should I start?
Yeah, you can start.
Okay, I'm going to start with a question.
So anasema ataanza na swali. Yeah.
Habari yenu.
Nzuri.
Very good. hello, my name is Shailia. I am so happy to be here with you today. It is a great honor to be able to speak with you. I want to speak at Philip's request about the role of thought.
So anasema gisi nilongea naye kumwambia aendelee kuongelesha kufuatana na mawazo. So anasema naye ndio ile ataongea hapo.
There is a very powerful invisible force in life.
Anasema mu maisha yetu kunakuwa force ni tunasema kunakuwa nguvu yenye tunakuwa nayo
we can't see it with our eyes but it affects our entire experience
sema saa zingine hatuwezi kuona na macho lakini inakuwaka
it is the energy of thought
nasema ile nguvu yenye nasema ni nguvu ya mawazo
For my whole adult life until I was 40 years old, I did not know about this powerful force.
Anasema hata yeye alikomara na gisa alikomara alikuwa hajui kama mawazo yuko vile.
I didn't know how it was affecting how I was feeling and living.
Na kuwa najua mawazo ni kitu gani inaweza leta kitu gani mzuri na kitu gani mbaya.
Yes. And then at 40 years old, I learned about the three principles and I started to understand about the role of thought.
Sasa kama sasa alifikisha miaka makumi nne akaanza jifunza hii mafundisho yenye nawe mlianza ona hapa miaka makumi nne akaanza elewa mawazo ni nini.
And today, as I was getting ready to speak with you, I asked God to give me a picture that would make it easy to understand.
So naye akasema leo hatakuwa na anataka tuongelesha, aliomba Mungu ampatie ile nguvu mzuri na mawazo mzuri aongeleshe msikie mzuri.
And God gave me the picture of going to the marketplace.
Na tena Mungu alimuonyesha kuonyesha like mawazo yenye like kiso naenda msoko.
I've never been to Africa, so I don't know how your marketplace looks like.
Anasema yeye hakuwaka mi Uganda na o Afrika yote bado kufika huku, lakini anasema hajui kama soko zetu zinakuwa namna gani.
But recently, I went to a very big marketplace in Turkey with many vegetables and fruits, cheeses and meats.
Lakini anasema siku zilizopita alikuwa take akaenda msoko ya take mwinchi nyingine akaona mamboga akaona matomate vitu mingi.
All of the sellers of these goods were calling me to come and buy what they had to offer.
Bali watu wenye wanachuruza walikuwa wanamuita kuja tuuzie, kuja tuuzie, kuja tuuzie.
So they know this, yes? They have this experience?
Wanasema mnajua ile kama unaingia msoko gisi watu wanakuita? Yeah, they know.
Yes, they know. So, but the market was very big. And some things that were being offered, they taste good to me. Some things I didn't need.
Sema bintu nilikuwa ndani vilikuwa bintu mingi na vingine hakuwa na vijua aliona tu msoko.
Some of the fruit looked really good and delicious. Other fruit looked old and not so delicious.
Sema zingine matunda niliona aliona ni mzuri jinsi unaziona tu naona eh ni mzuri eh lakini zingine aliona hizi zinaweza kuwa haziko mzuri.
The market was very, very large, really so far, hardly the eye could not finish seeing the many, many fruits and vegetables.
Anasema, zilikuwa vitu mingi, mingi msoko, na kuwa hawezi, biangalia, anasema, amevuona, vyote amemaliza.
So I knew there's no way I can take every offer being given to me. I have to be very selective about what I'm going to buy.
So naye akasema maybe kama nataka uza kitu. Nikujua atauza nini hata aenda na kamata kila kitu. Kwa juu vitu viko mingi. Anapaswa juu atauza nini mwambie vitu yote.
I knew I must pass by some of the offers and say, no, thank you.
Na alianza sema, hey, kuja uze, kuja, pana, asante, anapita, anapita, vingine, asante, kwa juu, atachagula chenye, atauze.
In fact, I knew I must say no many, many times.
So, alianza sema, hapana, mistaki tomato anaendelea alisema alikatala vya mingi mara mingi watu wenyokuwa namuita.
I had a budget of money and I needed to be selective about exactly what I needed to take home.
So anasema alikuwa na budget yake. Sasa huko ni 1000 na unaingia soko unasema wewe unataka nyama, unataka tomate, unataka kilo ngapi, na tena huko ni 1000. So alimwambia acha kwa jua anajua namna gani anataka uza nini.
I knew I needed to take the right fruits and the right vegetables and the right meat and the right cheese for me.
Nasema anajua kama anataka kitu yenye anataka ndio yenye atauza. Hakuna kusema kama anaingia msoko kila kitu yako namuita ndio yenye atauza. Anajua chenye anafanya nini chenye anataka.
This makes sense, right? We can't say yes to all of the offers on the market. We can't believe that everything is for us.
Anasema hatuwezi sema kila kitu ingia kila kitu tunapaswa jua namna gani tunataka nini.
Is this making sense to you that we can't take every offer on the entire large market?
Mko mna iko nauliza. Mko mnaelewa kama naingia msoko vitu viko mingi. Lakini mko mnaelewa chenye iko anasema kama naingia msoko hautakamata kila kitu.
Kuna kitu chenye utauza chenye utakonunua.
Yes, they understand that they need to be selective on what they want in the market.
Yes, we need to be wise about choosing what is right for us, the right use of our budget at the market.
So nasema ni mzuri tujue naingia msoko niko ni 1000. Nitauza nyama. Hapana. Na wengine naweza uza ile tomate hata ni za 500 nauza hata na matungu. Lakini sasa unaingia msoko huko unaenda kule kwenye wanauza nyama. Huko ni 1000.
Hautauza.
Aha. Niko na ile pale niko nawafundisha mawazo yako. Nasikia? Mawazo yako unajua huko ni 1000 utatumikisha nini? Na ile 1000 unajua chenye tauza na chenye naweza acha kuuza.
Yes. And this is the same is true when it comes to thought and our thinking.
Nasema njoo ile pamoja kama tunaanza ongea kwa mawazo.
Did you know that every day our brain offers us many thousands of different thoughts?
Na tena mnapaswa jua kwa gisi vyenye vinawaza vyenye tunawaza ndio vinajitetea gisi tunasikia.
All day long, thoughts, many, many thoughts are going through our mind, invisible, but we feel and see them in our personal awareness.
Nasema kila saa mawazo yako mingi yenye nakuja 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 sasa zingine napende kubadilisha, lakini wewe unajua chenye nataka.
The brain that's creating the thoughts is making many, many offers, just like the people at the vegetable market.
Nasema hiyo akili yenye iko inakuja yuko inaleta vitu mingi mawazo inakuja vitu yote iko inakuja mkichwa, lakini unajua jinsi mawazo iko inakuja mkichwa yako, lakini unajua huko ni 1000 hautaenda kuuza nini? Nyama. Mawazo yako yanakuja mbaya. Aha, nifanye nini? Nifuatilie vya mbaya.
Many, many of those thoughts were being offered to you by our brain. They're not for us. They're not good for us.
Nasema, vitu mingi vyenye vinakuja mkichwa yetu. Lakini hakuna kusema kila kitu inakuja kwa mzuri kwako.
We have to be selective which ones are for us, which ones are right for us, which ones lead us to a healthy mental state.
Yes.
I did not know this to be true until I was 40 years old.
Sema, hakuwa najua hii. Alijua kama nifikisha miaka makumi.
Before then, my brain would offer me thousands of thoughts every day, and I would take every single thought to be true.
nasema sasa kama nimaliza vile kuelewa kaanza na oh mawazo yanakuja mengi mtoto kina pasha chagua namna gani ya mzuri iko wapi ya mbaya iko wapi.
If my brain told me I wasn't a good enough wife, I believed it, although there was no proof that that was true.
Sema kama akili namwambia wewe kuwa ile mawazo yanambia wewe kuwa bibi mzuri hivi hivi na yeye kama anatembea vile itakuwa vile.
If my brain told me I was not attractive enough and I needed to be prettier, I believe that to be true and as well.
Nasema kama mama wazo yako na kile ndio kusema ah wewe hauko mzuri na tena ni mzuri angalia chenye taongezo kuwa mzuri anaitika vipi ile ndio gisi itaenda.
If my brain offered me difficult memories of past hardships, I took those as well.
Nasema kama kuna kuja vya mbaya vya zamani ndio vinawazo na wazo na wazo vinaendelea vinaendelea njoo vile utakuwa.
If my brain offered me scary thinking about the future, that something bad might happen to me in the future, I believe those thoughts as well.
Nasema kama ina vya mawazo inamletea mawazo mazuri ya kusema maybe binti utakuwa mzuri, maybe utakuwa mzuri like binti ya mzuri na tena itika vile njoo gisi atakuwa.
Innocently, I was using the power of thought in the wrong way.
So nasema alikuwa anatumikisha saa nyingine mawazo yake lakini njia ya mbaya.
I didn't know that I can be very selective about which of my thoughts to pay attention to give my power to.
Nasema hakuwa anajua namna gani anaweza kuona mawazo yake jinsi inaweza maybe kuwa ya mzuri.
I began to learn that just like at the fruit market, I'm going to be saying no to a lot of the thinking that my brain is offering me.
So naye akaanza jua iko msoko vitu viko mingi. Bina wanamuita ni mingi wenye wanasema kuja, kuja, kuja. Lakini sasa anapaswa jua, mimi nataka matulivu. Nasikia?
Yes. And I have within me the free will to be very selective which thoughts that I'm going to be having in my focus.
Nasema mwenyewe anapaswa jua mawazo gani yenye atatembea nayo.
This is what happened when I started to realize that.
So, nataka tuongelesha chenye aliona kama alianza ilikuwa natimkisha mawazo yangu mabaya. Nataka tuongelesha aliona nini sasa kama anza ileo.
If I was thinking of a difficult hardship in the past and it came to me, I would just let it pass through me.
Sema kama alikuwa na mawazo mabaya naendelea kuwaza mabaya naanza sema pia mabaya kani mimi nakuja anaacha naenda hadi achi kamati linabakia mwenyewe.
And I would wait for a more healthy thought to come, a thought that helped me to feel nicer, happier.
Sema tena pale anaendelea sasa kuchunga mawazo mazuri ikuje ya mbaya vinatoka anachunga mzuri.
When I would have a worrisome thought about the future that hadn't happened, I would let it just pass right through me.
Come again?
If I would have a worried thought about the future, what could happen to me, I would just let it pass right through me.
Nasema kama alikuwa anawaza zingine anaogopa bila yote anaacha vina toka chunga vya mpya.
I would wait for a nicer, more healthy thought that came with a nicer, more healthy feeling. I would do my best to just come back to the now. And when those thoughts would pass on by, I would fall into a good feeling. And I would feel more love and more joy and happiness. I got much more selective about which of the offers that my brain gives me for thinking that I take.
So ananza si ananza jua namna gani. Naona akili akili yetu ni kama vile kompyuta. Mnajua kompyuta? Kintu yenye naingia njoo hii. Sasa anasema ananza jua akili chini kitu akili namba
Yeah, this is what Philip means when he says the right use of thought and the wrong use of thought. He means being more selective about which thought we let into our spirit.
So nasema kama niona tunasema mawazo inatumika namna gani? Mawazo mazuri na mawazo mabaya ndio tunachokuwa tunasema. Unapaswa chagura kitu yenye itakusaidia. Nasikia? Bintu mingi viko nini? Kitu. Kitu njoo tunaita soko. Nasikia? Lakini kama naingia mwile soko, mwile mawazo, mwile akili yako, bintu viko vivi. Kwa juu ni ile akili ni kama kompyuta. Kila kitu naingia. Kila kitu naingia. Kila napasha jua, bintu naingia, na gani, iwe, hii tanisaidia, inawaki. Hii hakuna chini nisaidia. Naacha.
Yes. You and your spirit are very valuable and you deserve to be happy.
Nasema wewe na Mungu wako mko nguvu na unapaswa kuwa na furaha.
And this is the way to happiness.
Nasema hiyo njia yenye italeta furaha.
Yes. Living in the now.
Kuishi kwa leo. Kuishi, hakuna kuishi na ya zamani, hakuna faida yenye iko mwili.
Understanding that we don't have to believe every thought that our brain is offering us.
Na kujua, kila mawazo yenye nakuja makini yako, useme unapaswa itika ile. Kama ni ya mzuri, hakuna shida. Kama ni ya mbaya, acha fanya nini?
So I want to ask another question. Habari yeno. Okay. Asante sana. Asante sana. And Phillips, you can open up for asking questions or for sharing what they've seen or heard today.
Yeah, like their takeaways.
Yeah, if they saw something new for themselves today, what they understood or saw, or if they have any questions.
Okay. Anapenda kusikia ginyalibongeresha kufatana mawazo mubyelewa namna gani ku kintu yenye unasikia unasikia kama mtu anasema ah hii kintu sikuwa najua lakini naelewa mimi nitabadilisha hivi ndio chini anapenda kusikia. Eh. So yenye aliongea kufatana na mawazo kufatana na soko nini yenye umesikia unasema eh sikuwa najua ile lakini nimeelewa hivi ah na mimi nitanibadilisha. I have listened about control of the thoughts because I have listened that going to the market sometimes you go in the market with maybe overthinking and sometimes maybe kids at home have not eaten and you have gone there with 1,000 and you have to understand that sometimes you cannot buy any everything in the market. And to know that 1,000 can even buy like 2 half cakes. But when you reach in the market, you see a lot of products and you find you are thinking a lot. And seeing everything. And sometimes you don't have. And sometimes maybe you find because of many things someone is thinking about getting a debt from the market. And you find because you don't have money that day. And that day, when I don't have money, I will not go in the market. And that sometimes brings a lot of overthinking. But I have understood how we need to change the thoughts. And it has been so helpful to me what you shared. Together with God, we shall keep understanding and sharing.
Asante sana.
Aha. Mwingine kinyusikia? Mnapaswa mwamuuliza, mnapaswa mwambia tena mnajifunza. Eh. Hakuna kitu yenye mnasikia?
Tunasikia.
Aha.
Na mie
hakuna shida.
Naje ingine ku majambo ya kwigishije.
Even myself according to what you have shared about thought. I have had a very good feeling in me. Because like we mothers, sometimes we are having a lot, we are overthinking. Because how we are living in here in Nakivale. We didn't know how to buy everything. We use it just to go in our gardens, we dig, we get food, we go home. But reaching in Nakivale, things have changed. And the life, the way of living has made us to be down. And we had to think a lot. And sometimes when you find you don't have the possibility to send your children to school, you could feel a lot of hardship. Like for me, as example, I have five kids. And already I have like two who are not studying because I can't afford. Because I know it has not been easy to send them.
ariko amawazo kubera nyine kuko tugize iminsi duhafiga utwigisha.
But because we have spent some time following the teachings from Philips,
turagenda twumva muri kea nyine amawazo akaguma kaza tukavuga tuyaye Imana irahari.
We have come to see that controlling our thoughts is something so important.
Because
it has been very, very thoughts, but we have come to know how to control. But together we know that God is there. And we know that we are hopeful that things will be better. Because even I didn't know that I can live all this time in Nakivale, but I'm living. Because I was living knowing that maybe I won't afford, we won't live, but I see my life is changing. And together with God, we are getting some food, the kids are eating. And we are seeing life changing. Okay, thank you so much.
Asante sana.
Okay. Aha, mwingine? Leta kiti yako hapa. We have learned about thoughts, and it has been so helpful because sometimes we have to use what we have. You have mentioned how we go into the market and we become selective. And we have understood how to go in the market and we understand our budget and how to be shopping what we need. With this good thinking, we are very much appreciative to see that we have known to understand how to control our thinking. Thank you so much. They are saying, you keep coming, they are happy for you.
Asante sana, asante sana.
Asante, huh? And we have seen that what you are sharing with us is very true, because we are seeing that if we know how to control our thinking, then also our feelings will be much positive. Because we have come to Nakivale and we are living somehow better in our countries. But living in Nakivale, of course, it has been hard and we don't have option, but only wisdom to overthink. But for all this time, we have been receiving 3P teachings. We have seen the calmness in our hearts. As you mentioned, some of us have come to understand that our brain can receive everything, but we need to understand how, what we are supposed to retain and what we are supposed to make like pass away and go. Because sometimes if you see about going to the market and you don't have money to buy something there, then sometimes it will also bring overthinking. Even when you get debts, you find it is also hard. But it is good to understand where to sit and how to control our thinking. And not to over ask others about what they have. And we are happy that for God's grace we are getting some food and living. And we are living in all that hardship, but since we started receiving or learning from these three principal teachings, we are seeing a very good change in our lives. And we are seeing even in our heads, we are feeling the we are living like we are having pure minds. Even in our hearts, we don't feel hardship. So together with God, we are so much appreciative for these teachings.
Asante sana.
Asante, aha. Mwingine? Kwa mwingine anataka ongea? Leta kitabu. Wajuu, napenda ongea na kusikia na kuona. And for us, we are refugees, and of course, we are having a lot of property in our home countries. And we have seen, like, reaching here in Uganda, we have even failed to afford even having a hen. Like, you get sick, you don't even afford to treat yourself. Even we lack food, like supporting our kids and our families at home. And you find children are just sitting at home, not going to school. So, because of all those hardships, we could think a lot. But because we have been lucky to have three principles and have these three teachings, together with God to give you a very positive heart to come and share to us. And to see that you have thought about us and you are sharing with us, and we see like our negativity that we used to think, now we are thinking positive. Because of that, we are still hopeful.
It's
saying that together with your energy that you are putting on to share to us, and with God, we shall like overcome anything that comes.
No God do not forget that to Tamuruzi.
Yes. Saying they are so much thankful. And we are feeling happy because we have come to visit them. May God bless you.
Asante sana.
Asante. Kuko mwingine mwenye anataka kuja? Acha hii. Pita.
Mfika huko.
It's good that you have come to share to us. And of course, what you have been taught here, it is to see how we control our thinking. Because we have been having a lot of thinking here. Because we passed a lot of hardships before. We had a lot of things, our cows, sheep, everything. And we had already built good houses in our home countries. But because of war, we left all those. And all our domestic animals were
rooted.
But what you are sharing to us, we are like we are seeing the calmness. And we are like our thinking, our overthinking is now becoming
calm.
Because since we started like teachings of three principles here, we have come to understand that love is important. And already our overthinking have already passed away, and we are now thinking now. Because here there are a lot of things, but to eat them because of money. But because sometimes we lack finance, then the same way you find children are not studying. But together with God, we are seeing a very good change. And with God, with God, everything is possible.
No, nega. Nivisa kuko mwemu makutwigisha mutugarura mawazo, amawazo akaba makeya butwe.
It is good that you are sharing it as three principles, and we are so much appreciating what we are receiving. Asante.
Asante. Asante.
Yeah. Uko mwingine? Ikara kwa hili. We still have one coming, and this one got an accident when they were rearing cows in the bush, and they had to shoot him the leg. That's why you see he's moving with the walking stick.
Yes.
Yeah. So for me, I'm very happy for what you have shared to us. And we are seeing good change. Because I'm a lame man, sometimes overthinking comes. Because sometimes when I sleep, I think, now me, a man, what am I going to eat in Nakivale? I just sit home, I don't have work. I overthink, I used to overthink a lot. But I've come to understand that together with God, the positive thinking has to be there. But we are so much happy for the sleep sharings, because we are seeing hope coming to us. And together with you and God, be happy, and we are already happy. Asante sana.
Asante, asante sana.
We have one mom coming also.
Yes.
This is a group of many old, there are many old people. But they love sleepy because he's overthinking because they have lost a lot.
Yes.
But they are so much helpful. So we have Mze. Yeah. So this Mze is 90 years.
Tusa kwetwa basaza tudashoboye twabaga mu gihugu cyacu tawagura gahinga tawagura gaho yubaka teka paru kubaka gusa.
So in our home area it was goodness because we could have our houses, we could have our cows, we could do everything free.
Dufite inka, dufite ibitungwa, dufite inkoko, ukora muragira uko ushaka.
Having domestic animals and we could sell and eat whatever we want. We didn't know that one day we can even live there. Because we could just dig and get food and we get milk free.
Abantu tuza muri iki gihugu ntitwari tukizipi ari gupfa kumva amakuru ngo ino tukabumva gusa.
Because of the war we have been like we have migrated from our country to this new area.
Turahaza tumaze gushika hano tuza ntacyo dushoboye, abenshi naho bavuga ngo barajya mu cyaro ntitunahazi, ntiturashije, turabaho ngahimuhira.
And also eating has been very hard, but you have come to see how to control.
Guhamagare uguma kutwigisha kandi nyine mitwingi n'izi rumutana.
And we are very happy to understand that we need to be selective on what we buy in the market. And through the teachings, we are very happy that we have come to understand how to control
ourselves.
So we thank you so much because you have come to cool our thinking.
Asante.
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 Okay. So that is the group, and they have been very happy. We are very happy to be with you today. And we are very thankful. These teachings have helped us.
Yaradufashije imitwe bakituriza twadutekereza tukagwara za sitoma zigatomboka kubera amawazo.
We used to even overthink and you find we are just living there as sick people.
No, nigga. Bikurikiranye na miga yawe no kukubona byaradufashije.
But through these sleepy teachings, it has helped us so much to cool our overthinking.
Byaradufashije twumva turaturije mu mitwe itangira gutekereza neza.
We have gained hope and we are thinking positive.
No name, Washing. I'm going to Magambo Yahoo. No Kukuona, Ni, Shuti, Wohereje, Igumaku Twigish, Wago, Neza, Kanditrishima.
She's saying, seeing you come here and Philips and group coming to be teaching every time they come to visit. to visit them. They are very much appreciating what we are sharing to them. Okay, asante.
Asante.
We have one more.
Yes, yes. Whoever wants to speak, we have time today.
I'm called Nyafraha Esperance. I'm very happy that you have thought about us. Nyarugugu is very big, but we thank God that we are ready in this group receiving these teachings. We appreciate you so much because we have come to understand that if we are having overthinking and mostly think about the past we passed through in our home areas, then we shall still live in negative. Despite of many challenges in the camp, limited food, water, children not going to school, but we are lucky that we have come to understand about the role of thought. These repeat teachings have been helpful to us. May God bless you.
Asante.
Okay. We thank God for what we are receiving today. Because what we are sharing here is so good, we feel good. And we are seeing what God can do for us. Really, it is very good. We thank God that we are here receiving these teachings. Because of overthinking from our home areas, we used to think very good when we are in our home area. We were living there with plenty of food, good water, medical care, and the rest. We were living happy. But because of negativity of other tribes and other people, the country had to change and the wars broke out. The burning of the houses and the killing of people happened and we had to run there. Here we are receiving a lot of challenges, but we are very happy that with the three teachings we have been able to understand how to control our life. Because sometimes we could have negative feeling, but we don't know how to control. But we are seeing a very good woman and we are very happy to have you today and we thank God for you.
komeze kutwigisha imitima yacu no kuvyumurisa cyane ku magambo meza no kutubwira.
And we pray that you never get tired of thinking about us, of teaching us, and we know that everything will be okay.
Ushimene uyu mwana w'Imana wo hije wanyuzemo kuba mu kuzitanya ni kwadufasha hano.
And we also thank Philips and the group for always coming to our group to give sharing of hope. May God bless you.
Asante, Asante.
Asante, Sana. Yeah, so that is how it is. And the group is so much relaxed for what you shared to them, and they have loved how you came to this group, and they are saying that you always come to share.
Phillips, do you mind if I share say a few things back from what I heard?
Yes.
Do you have a few more moments?
Yeah.
Okay. I'm so very touched by everyone who shared.
Nasema ana kubyenye mmongeresha vimemu anasikia eh anasikia umepita mabintu ya namna gani amesikia kila mtu kisha limongeresha.
I am so amazed at the love and the strength that is coming through you when you share.
Anasema anasikia mzuri kwa nguvu yenye gisi mko mnaongea, nguvu yenye meisha sikia kufatana na hii mafundisho, kusema na yumu mungilisha naye anasikia nguvu.
Sometimes we have the most spiritual growth in the most difficult of situations.
Nasema saa zingine tunakuwa na nguvu gisa yongezi ni zinakuwa kandani.
I'm so happy you've understood about the role of thought and overthinking.
Nasema yuko na furaha sana kuona mumeelewa kuwaza sana binasaidia nini, hakuna kuwaza mzuri binasaidia nini. Yuko so anasema anafurahi sana kufuatana na gisi mmeongelesha alielewa kama mko kitu yenye mmekamkisikia.
I too have many days where I'm overthinking.
Saa zingine anasema naye anakuwa alikuwa anawaza sana nyuma.
And I'm so happy that I understand that I can quiet my mind and find my way back to wisdom.
Ina furaha sana kuona kama anajua kama anatuliza akili yake, akili inarudia.
For me too, learning to quiet my mind changed everything for more positive.
Nasema yeye kujifunza kutuliza akili yake ni kitu chenye kimsaidia sana.
And my hope is that you will share this also with other people who are also not here today.
Anasema yuko natumaini kujua kama vyenye mnasikia hapa na kama unafika mjio na kutana rafiki au safari zingine au kanisa unaongelesha mtu mwingine unasaidia mtu mwingine.
It's like when you throw a pebble in the lake.
Come again?
It's like when you throw a pebble in the lake, in the water. It makes waves and ripples across the entire lake. And today we are already very blessed.
Sema, sai, tumeisha kuwa na bahati,
Because we have this time to connect with each other, see each other, listen to each other. This is a tremendous gift of spiritual connection.
Tunasema hiyo ni kitu ni zawadi yenye Mungu anatupatia.
Your being here today is a tremendous gift to me.
Nasema mwe kuona mmetoka manyumba zenyu mnakuja kumsikiliza naye anaona ni zawadi kwake.
Thank you for listening today and sharing with me today.
Nasema asante kwa kumsikiliza kwa leo. Yeah, thank you so much. We are very happy that we got you today, Shailia, and it was so powerful, and everyone is feeling very well.
Thank you, Phillips, for translating. You did such a good job today. So good.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you too for coming along and share. Yeah.
Yes, maybe we see each other again. Say hello to the team for me too, okay? Can you hear me,
Come
Phillips?
Again?
I said, I'll see you soon and say hello to the team.
All right. Anasema, yeye iko naenda, lakini tutakuwa tunaonana. So, mnaweza mpatia tu bara naenda.
Bye. Bye-bye. Bye-bye. Bye-bye.
Okay. Bye-bye.